morning, students. How are you today? Hope you are staying safe. Welcome to today's lesson. In our previous lesson, last week's lesson, we did area of friendships. We have treated area of rectangles, square, parallelogram, trapezium. And I remember telling you to go further to find out the formula for finding the area of triangle and circle. And that will be our next topic. Coming to today, I expect that by the end of this lesson, you should be able to find the area of triangles, area of circles, and find the radius of a circle when the area is given. Let's start with triangle. The formula of finding the area of a triangle is half base times height, or we say base times height over 2. But that is not the only formula for finding the area of triangle. We have about 3 formulas for finding the area of triangle. We have a formula when we are given 2 sides of a triangle with an included angle. We have another formula when you are given 3 sides of a triangle without the angle. So it's not a point that you'll be given the height before you can find the area of a triangle. But for your level, you just deal with base and height. Now, take this example. Find the area of the triangle below. You remember when we treated plane shapes, when we were talking about parallelogram, I say that because the sides are slant, the sides are not straight. We don't consider the length of the sides as the height of the shape. But when we come to something like square and rectangle, the edges are straight. So the length of the sides is the same with the height of the shape. Because of that, any shape that has a slant edge, when you come to the side of the shape, you notice there's only a dotted line that runs from the top side to the end, to the base, telling you the actual height of the shape, to tell you that the height of the shape is different from the length of the side of the shape. Let's look at the triangle also. It has slant edges, and you can see the dotted line that runs from top here to under the shape, telling you that the height of this triangle is 6 here. Find the area, half base times height. We know that base means under. So you say 1 over 2 times base, which is 10 over 1, times height, which is 6 over 1. You cancel out. 2 can go. 2 divides 2 12, then 2 divides 10, 5. And the numerator, we have 5 and 6, 5 times 6. And the denominator, there is nothing again. So our answer is 30 centimeter squared. Example 2. Find the height of the triangle with base 15 cm and area 60 cm squared. When you look at this question, you find out that in the first one, we are given the base and the height. While in the second one, we are given the height, the base, but we are looking for the height and the area is also. What do you do? Firstly, write your formula. This is half base times height. Bring out the value of every parameter in the formula from your question. So our question, our base is 15 cm. Our height is unknown. We say height based on that. Then our area is 60 cm squared. Put all the values, then it falls into the formula. On this side is our area. We replace that area with 60 because it's given. Because 1 over 2 times base is 15, so 15 over 1 times height. Because height is not given, we represent the height with h. What do you do? You cancel out 5th class level, and this job the bottom can cancel. So what do you do? Multiply the numerator and the denominator. 6 is 3 here, 1 times 15 is 15, times h, 15 here. All over 2 times 1, 2. You cross multiply, and for multiplication, 50 h, 1, 60 times 2. Which is 60 times 2 is 120. Which means 15 h is equal to 120. What do you do? You divide both sides by the coefficient of h. You remember your algebraic expression, where the number that stands in front of the alphabet is known as the coefficient. You divide by 15, 15 divides itself, 15 divides 120, and therefore our h is equal to 8 centimeters. Not centimeter squared. It is only the area that you put power of 2, but the other ones you are looking for just stand on their own without power 2. You just have CM, whatever you need to use. Now let's go back to circle. The area of the circle is pi r squared. Where pi 22 over 7. Or 3.142. Or 3.1 over 1 over 7. In some cases, for most many, most instructors, you could be asked, use your pad to be 3.142. When it is being specified, they want you to use that decimal value of pi to work out. In that case, you don't use 22 over 7. You use 3.142. Now, let's take an example. But if you're not given, if it's not being specified, you can go further with your 22 over 7. Anyone you like. So let's take an example. Find the area of a circle with length is 14 cm. As usual, lift the formula. Pick out that area is equal to pi r squared, where our pi is 22 over 7. Our r is 14 cm. And remember, anything raised to power 2 means that thing times itself. So r raised to power 2 is r times r. We now come to this place, 22 over 7 times 14 over 1 times 14 over 1. 7 times 1, 7 times 6 is 7. 7 times 6 is 14. 2. Nothing can divide the thing. You just multiply it and get 660 centimeter squared. Second example. Find the radius of a circle whose area is 164 cm. When you look at this, we are not looking for radius, no longer area, but area is given as 164 cm. First thing, bring down your formula, pi r squared. Area on this side, what is equal? Pi times r times r. What is equal? Nothing can cancel. You multiply the numerators. This is equal to 22 r raised to power 2. All over 7. When we get to this place, we first multiply. Our first multiplication becomes 154.97 equals 22 r raised to power 2. Because 154.97 equals 1078 equals 22 r squared. We divide both sides by coefficient of r squared, which is 22, and we should get 49 equals after very we have to contend with the equal r raised to power. Remember, we are looking for value of r, not r raised to power. So, when we have power, what do we do to remove the power? We find the square root of both sides. That's how we came here. Find the square root of square root of r raised to power 2 is r. Square root of contend is 7. 3,000 of r is equal to 7 centimeters squared. From these examples we have solved, I believe that when you are given any question on finding radius of a circle, area of a circle, any whether base or height of a triangle, the area of a triangle, you should be able to get it. Now, coming to our assignment, look at the assignment. You write your assignment, submit as usual. Thank you very much. See you next time.